Hello students, welcome to today's lectures on AGM 311, Introduction to Farm Mechanization, Study Section 3. The title of today's topic is Internal Combustion Engines. Introduction. An internal combustion engine, ICE, is a heat engine where the combustion of fuel occurs with an oxidizer, which is usually air, in a combustion chamber that is an integral part of the working fluid flow circuit. In an internal combustion engine, the expansion of the high temperature and high pressure gases produced by combustion applies direct force to some components of the engine. The force is applied typically to pistons, turbine blades, rotor, or a nozzle. This force moves the component over a distance, transforming chemical energy into useful mechanical energy. In this study section, you will be familiar with the description of internal combustion engine and their operational cycle. Learning outcome on study section 3. On completion of this study section, you should be able to 1. Describe internal combustion engine and external combustion engine, define certain terms used with engines, and lastly describe all the cycles of operations of a four-stroke engine. Principles of internal combustion engine. Combustion means the burning of fuel in the presence of air or oxygen. Internal combustion engine ICE involves the burning of fuel in a confined system for the generation of heat energy and liberation of mechanical energy. Examples of fuel are kerosene, petrol, and diesel. Examples of internal combustion engines are motor cars, which use petrol engine. We have motorcycle, which uses petrol engine as well. We have tractors, which use petrol and diesel engines. We have generator, which uses petrol and diesel engine. We also have external combustion engine, ECE, where combustion takes place outside a closed confinement. Example of such combustion engine are the railways, steam traction engine. We also have gas turbine engine. Therefore, the two basic types of internal combustion engine commonly used on the farm are the petrol and diesel engines. Petrol engines are spark ignition engine, SIE, and diesel engines are compression ignition engines. Both engines obtain their power by burning the liquid fuel inside the engine cylinder. Terms used with engines. To be able to understand the differences between spark ignition and compression ignition engines, there is need to know and be familiar with some terms commonly used with the engine. Starting with the clearance volume. Clearance volume is the space above the piston within the cylinder. We also have the top dead center, TDC, which is the position of the crank and piston when the piston is further away from the crankshaft. While moving upward, the piston cannot go beyond the top dead center. Then we also have the bottom dead center, BDC, which is the position of the crank and the piston when the piston is nearest to the crankshaft. The piston cannot move down beyond the bottom dead center while going downwards. We also have bore. Bore represents the internal diameter of the cylinder. We have the stroke. Stroke is the distance between the bottom dead center and the top dead center. We have the swept volume, which is the volume of the space between the top dead center and the bottom dead center. It is also called piston displacement. We also have engine capacity, which is the swept volume of all the cylinders. And lastly, we have the engine size. This is given by the bore and the stroke of the engine. Cycle of operation. The moment an internal combustion engine starts working, it operates in either of two ways. 1. Two-stroke cycle or 2. Four-stroke cycle. A cycle is a series of events which are repeated in regular order of sequence in the operation of an engine. In the two-stroke cycle, a power stroke takes place at every revolution of the crank. In other words, the crankshaft makes one revolution and the piston makes two strokes in each cycle. Similarly, in the four-stroke cycle, a power stroke occurs at every other revolution of the crank. This translates to the crankshaft making two complete revolutions and the piston's four strokes. Here, a stroke is the movement of the piston from one end of the cylinder to the other. Principles of four-stroke petrol engine. The first stroke is called the intake stroke. The inlet valves open to allow the mixture of fuel and air enter into the vacuum in the cylinders. At this time, the piston is pushed downwards from the top dead center to the bottom dead center. It should be noted that the outlet or exhaust valve remains closed. Now, on the second stroke, which is called the compression stroke, both the inlet and exhaust valve are closed. The piston is pushed upward by the connection rod or connecting rod to compress the mixture of fuel and air in the combustion chamber or clearance volume, thus increasing the temperature of the mixture. Now, the third stroke is called the power stroke. With the approach of the piston towards the top dead center in the second stroke, the mixture of the fuel and air is ignited with a spark arising from the spark plug, causing them to burn. The resulting expanded gas pushes the piston from the top dead center to the bottom dead center. At this point, both the inlet and exhaust valves are closed. And lastly, we have the fourth stroke, which is called the exhaust stroke. The crankshaft rotates to push the connecting rod upward, which in turn moves the piston upwards from the bottom dead center to the top dead center. In this process, the product of combustion is pushed out of the cylinder through the opening exhaust valve of the cylinder. It is also to be noted that the inlet valve remains closed during the fourth stroke. The cycle and the series of events continue as long as the engine operates. Principle of four-stroke diesel engine. The four-stroke obtained in petrol engine are obtainable too in diesel engine. That is, intake or induction, compression, power and exhaust strokes. The major difference lies in the way the diesel fuel is burned. In four-stroke diesel engine, in the intake process, the inlet valve opens while the exhaust valve closes. Air only is supplied to the cylinder, forcing the piston downwards. Then, during the compression stroke, the piston moves from the bottom dead center to the top dead center, thus compressing the already admitted air, and its temperature becomes very high as a result of compression. Both the inlet and exhaust valve are closed during the compression stroke. Then, during the power stroke of a diesel engine, immediately the compression stroke is ended, atomized or fine spray of diesel fuel is injected into the very hot compressed air, resulting spontaneously into burning, which pushes the piston downwards for the power stroke. Both the inlet and exhaust valves are still closed. The direct delivery of diesel fuel to the cylinder is accomplished by the injector. And lastly, we have the exhaust strokes. In exhaust stroke, the piston moves upward to push out the product of combustion through the outlet or exhaust valve that is now opened. The inlet valve is closed during the exhaust stroke. Thank you for listening. I hope to see you in the next class. Do have a good day.